Oyster shells were seeded with grit to enable them to grow pearls. The pearls were later collected by divers and harvested. They looked like this. Today there's a Perthing lugger on display. It's a gaff-rigged catch in the style of 19th century European and North American trading and fishing vessels. The arrival of the Streeter's fleet in 1879 marked the first luggers in Broome. There's a small historical display. The Japanese divers who died are remembered by this memorial overlooking Roebuck Bay. More meaningful is a watch at the Japanese and Chinese cemetery. The Japanese cemetery, which dates back to the very early Perthing era, shows the close connection between Japan and Broome. During their years of employment in the industry, a great many men lost their lives due to drowning and divers paralysis. Also, quite a few were killed in the 1908 cyclone. It's recorded that in the 1887 and 1935 cyclones, there were 140 men killed in each. In 1914, divers paralysis claimed the lives of 33 men. There are 707 graves for 919 people. Let's go through the gates and have a quick wander around. Not all the headstones are in the cemetery. These are at the Broome Historical Museum. Next to the Japanese cemetery is the Chinese cemetery. There is a small Chinatown in Broome, and the Chinese provided this labor to run the shops. A wander through the Pioneer Cemetery. Not a pioneer, perhaps, but close enough. This lizard was wandering around in the museum. Thanks for joining me on this trip to Historical Broome and the Broome Museum. My name is Don, and I wish you a very pleasant day.